Bonjour and welcome, viewers and students, to Let's Speak French, Parlons Français. These lessons on basic French are short and easy. And if you follow the program regularly, I can assure you that very soon you will be able to understand French quite easily. The previous session focused on the imperfect tense. In today's class, we will focus on direct object pronouns known as complément d'objet direct or simply COD. This lesson and the next two lessons of this chapter are interrelated. So this third lesson can be considered as part one of the series. Today's lesson on COD has been divided into three sections. In this first section, I will read out a French text in which the direct object pronouns occur several times. Then in the next section, I will explain all about these pronouns. And finally, in the third section, we will do an exercise to revise what we learned in today's session. This text consists of a dialogue that takes place between a group of friends who are shopping at a mall. Au centre commercial. Monique. Oh, comme elle est belle cette robe. Je veux l'acheter. Nathalie. Tu la portes d'abord. Si elle te va bien, tu la prends. Après quelque temps. Monique. J'adore la robe, surtout la coupe. Mais je n'aime pas trop la couleur. Nathalie, tu préfères quelle couleur? Monique, le bleu sarcelle, tu le connais? Nathalie, c'est le turquoise, n'est-ce pas? C'est une belle couleur aussi, mais je pense que cette couleur te convient très bien. Maintenant, regarde ce que j'ai choisi. Comment tu trouves ce pantalon blanc? Je l'aime bien. Monique, pas moi, je ne l'aime pas. Tu peux le porter de temps en temps, mais ce n'est pas pratique. C'est un pantalon évasé tout blanc. Tu vas certainement le salir. Nathalie. T'as raison. J'aurais du mal à le laver. Bon, il fait tard, on doit partir. Voyons si Lucie a trouvé son livre. Elle le cherche depuis longtemps. Au deuxième étage. Lucie. Bonjour. Je cherche le rayon des livres de recettes. Vendeuse, vous le trouverez le long de l'allée centrale. Lucie, je l'ai déjà cherché là. Il y a des best-sellers sur l'allée centrale. Vendeuse, les livres de recettes sont juste à côté. Lucie, c'est vrai? Je ne les ai pas vus. Bon, merci. Nathalie, Lucie, tu as trouvé le livre? Lucie, pas encore, mais je crois que c'est ici. Oui, elle est là. Monique, tiens, ma sœur vient d'acheter ce même livre. C'est moins cher si tu le commandes en ligne. Si tu veux, je le fais ce soir. Lucie, d'accord, on peut rentrer alors, si vous avez fini avec vos achats. Monique et Nathalie, oui, on rentre. So this was a short text where the direct object pronouns have been used several times. In the next section, I will explain to you all about these pronouns. Let me begin by first explaining what an object is. An object is a person or a thing that is the receiver of an action. The subject, on the other hand, is the person or the thing that does the action. The action is always expressed through the verb. The subject and the verb are essential elements in a sentence, and no sentence would be grammatically correct if one of them was missing. The object, however, is not an essential component. But there are situations when an object is equally necessary. This happens when the verb is a transitive verb. A transitive verb is one that always goes hand in hand with an object. This object may follow the verb either directly or indirectly. When the object is preceded by a preposition, it is said to be an indirect object. If there isn't any preposition between the object and the verb, the object is said to be a direct object. In today's lesson, we will study direct objects. Let me illustrate through examples what a direct object is. Je lis un livre. I am reading a book. Elle soigne sa sœur. She tends her sister. In both the sentences, the underlined term is the direct object. As you may have noticed, it's not just the noun, but also the determiners, that is to say, the indefinite article un and the possessive adjective sa, which are also underlined. The reason for including the determiners is because in French, a noun can never be used on its own. In these two sentences, the direct object is pretty straightforward. But in longer sentences, it may be slightly tricky to identify the direct object. In such cases, always remember that the direct object is a noun that follows a verb that answers the question what or whom. Let me illustrate with an example. Hier, pendant la pause de midi, je lisais un roman français très intéressant écrit par Jules Verne. Yesterday, during the lunch break, I was reading a very interesting French novel written by Jules Verne. To find out if roman is the direct object of this sentence, we ask the question, what was I reading? If instead of a noun, the object was a person, the question would be, with whom? So now that you know what a direct object of a verb is, let me explain to you what a direct object pronoun is. A pronoun is always a word that replaces a noun or a phrase previously mentioned in order to avoid repetition. So a direct object pronoun or COD, that is complément d'objet direct, is a pronoun that replaces a direct object. In other words, a COD can be used when the two following conditions are met. The noun to be replaced refers to a person or a thing. The noun to be replaced is specific, that is to say, the noun is preceded by a specific determiner such as a definite article, le, la, les, a possessive adjective, mon, ma, me, etc., or a demonstrative adjective like ce, cet, etc. If the direct object is preceded by an indefinite article, un, une, des, it cannot be replaced with a COD. In such cases, the pronoun en must be used. For example, il collectionne des timbres. He collects stamps. C'est vrai, moi aussi j'en collectionne. Is it? I too collect them. In this example, if we ask the question, what does he collect? We find that the answer is des timbres, which is the direct object of the verb collectionner, which means to collect. However, since the noun is preceded by the indefinite article des, it cannot be replaced by a COD. Now that you know when to use a direct object pronoun in French, let me list them out to you. I will illustrate each COD with an example. Manuel hates me. Manuel me déteste. Manuel loves me. Manuel m'aime. He hates you. Il te déteste. He loves you. Il t'aime. We hate him. Nous le détestons. We love him. Nous l'aimons. You all hate her. Vous la détestez. You all love her. Vous l'aimez. Manuel hates us. Manuel nous déteste. Manuel loves us. Manuel nous aime. They hate you all. Ils vous détestent. They love you all. Ils vous aiment. You hate them. Tu les détestes. You love them. Tu les aimes. Three things can be observed from these examples. The two forms, le and la, of the third person singular, the position of the direct object pronoun, and the phenomenon of elision that occurs when the verb begins with a vowel. We'll take up each of these points one by one. The third person singular has two forms, a masculine form and a feminine form. If the direct object is a masculine singular noun, it is replaced by le. Tu dessines le portrait. Tu le dessines. You are drawing it, the portrait. Je décris le paysage. Je le décris. I am describing it, the scenery. If the direct object is a feminine singular noun, it is replaced by la. Je mange la tarte. Je la mange. I am eating it, a tart. Des mouches dérangent la vache. Des mouches la dérangent. Flies are disturbing it, the cow. In the text, we have two examples of this. Tu la portes d'abord. You wear it first, the dress. Le bleu sarcelle, tu le connais? Teal, do you know it? Position of the direct object pronoun. The direct object pronoun always precedes the verb whose object it is. If the verb is conjugated in the compound tense, such as the compound past, the direct object pronoun will precede the auxiliary verb. Il nous a vus hier. He saw us yesterday. Tes parents t'ont cherché partout. Your parents looked everywhere for you yesterday. In the text, we have an example like this. Je ne les ai pas vus. I didn't see them. The cookery books. If the sentence has two verbs, the direct object pronoun is placed immediately before the second verb. Je voulais t'appeler, mais il faisait tard. I wanted to call you, but it was late. Communiquez avec cette femme. Elle pourra vous aider. Contact this woman. She will be able to help you all. Here is an example like this from the text. Tu peux le porter de temps en temps. You can wear it occasionally. The dress. When the sentence is in the negative form, ne precedes the direct object pronoun. Il ne m'invite pas pour le mariage. He won't invite me to the marriage. Ses paroles ne vous hantent pas? Her words don't haunt you? There is one example like this in the text. Pas moi, je ne l'aime pas. Not me, I don't like them, the trousers. The phenomenon of elision is observed for me, te, le, and la when the following verb, that is the transitive verb or the auxiliary verb, begins with a vowel or a mute H. J'espère que tu ne vas pas m'oublier. I hope you won't forget me. La police t'a arrêté? The police stopped you. Vous huilez le grill. Vous l'huilez. You oil it. Il écoute la musique trop fort. Il l'écoute trop fort. He listens to it very loudly, the music. Here is one example from the text. Je l'ai déjà cherché là. I've already looked for it there, the cookery books. You may have noticed in some of the translations of the examples I've given you that the direct object is an indirect object in English. Since the English language and the French language are not the same, it is possible that sometimes a French transitive verb may have a direct object, but its English equivalent will not, and vice versa. For example, j'attends le bus, I'm waiting for the bus. Elle a payé ses études en travaillant, she paid for her education by working. And finally, let me show you one last but very important point regarding the direct object pronoun. In French, when a verb having the auxiliary avoir is conjugated in the compound past or any other compound tense, the past participle does not agree with the gender and number of the subject. For example, ils ont fermé les fenêtres car il commençait à faire froid. They closed the windows because it was getting cold. In this sentence, fermer, to close, is a verb that takes the auxiliary avoir in the compound past. Therefore, the past participle, which is fermer, does not agree with the subject. But if the direct object of the verb fermer, which is les fenêtres, precedes the verb, the past participle agrees with the direct object. For example, ils les ont fermés car il commençait à faire froid. They closed them because it was getting cold. Here, les fenêtres has been replaced with les. If you remember, the direct object pronoun is always placed before the verb. So when the direct object precedes the verb, the past participle agrees with the direct object. Since les fenêtres is a feminine plural noun, the past participle takes the feminine plural form, that is es. If the direct object pronoun is feminine singular, we add an e at the end of the past participle. And if the pronoun is masculine plural, we add an s unless the past participle already ends with an s. Here are a few more examples. J'ai trouvé ta clé, je l'ai trouvé. I have found it, your key. Nous avons finalement résolu le problème. Nous l'avons finalement résolu. We have finally solved it, the problem. Tu as rangé tes vêtements dans le placard. Tu les as rangés dans le placard. You have arranged your clothes in the cupboard. Please note, there is no agreement when the direct object follows the verb. Before we proceed to the next section and revise what we learned today, let me summarize the lesson on direct object pronouns or COD, that is, complément d'objet direct. A transitive verb always has an object which is either a person or a thing. When this object follows immediately after the verb without the intermediary of a preposition, the object is known as a direct object. The seven inflected forms of the direct object pronouns are me, te, le, la, nous, vous, les. The first four singular forms change to M apostrophe, T apostrophe and L apostrophe when the following verb begins with a vowel or a mute H. The third person singular has two separate forms, a masculine singular form and a feminine singular form. When the direct object pronoun is used instead of the direct object, it precedes the verb. When the verb is conjugated in a compound tense, such as the compound past, the se or de precedes the auxiliary verb. When this happens, the past participle agrees in number and gender with the direct object. In this third section, we will revise what we learned in today's session on direct object pronouns. A short exercise has been provided below. We need to replace the direct object with the appropriate se or de and make the necessary changes to the sentences. Nous avons appelé le médecin. Médecin is a masculine singular noun, hence it will be replaced with le. The past participle will remain the same since the direct object is le médecin. Nous l'avons appelé. This sentence translates as we have called him, the doctor. Vous avez invité vos étudiants chez vous. The direct object of the verb inviter is vos étudiants. Since this object is masculine plural, it will be replaced with les. The past participle will require an S. Vous les avez invités. This sentence translates as you have invited them home, your students. Elle a vu ma sœur avec Pierre. The direct object of the verb voir is ma sœur. Since this object is feminine singular, it will be replaced with la. The past participle will require an E. Elle l'a vu avec Pierre. This sentence translates as she saw her with Peter, my sister. Depuis plusieurs mois, les souvenirs douloureux de leur enfance ont hanté les jeunes réfugiés. The direct object of the verb hanter is les jeunes réfugiés. Since this object is masculine plural, it will be replaced with les. The past participle will require an S. Depuis plusieurs mois, les souvenirs douloureux de leur enfance les ont hantés. This sentence translates as, since many months, the painful memories of their childhood have haunted them, the young refugees. Ma mère a bien rangé les chambres. The direct object of the verb ranger is les chambres. Since this object is feminine plural, it will be replaced with les. The past participle will require an es. Ma mère les a bien rangés. This sentence translates as my mother has arranged them well, the rooms. With this, we come to the end of our third lesson. This lesson was divided into three sections. In the first section, I read out a French text in which the direct object pronouns occurred several times. In the second section, I explained all about these pronouns. And finally, in the third section, we revised today's lesson by doing an exercise. I hope you enjoyed today's session. In the next lesson, we'll examine the indirect object pronouns. I hope to see you in the next session. Thank you and à bientôt. See you soon.